Hello and welcome to Linear Algebra. This is actually not the first Linear Algebra video that I'm recording. I have already recorded and posted over 160 individual videos. In fact, you can see the remnants of the last one I just recorded on the blackboard behind me. And all along, I've been thinking about the best way to do this introduction. There's a number of things I could talk about in this introduction. I could give you a few of the thousands upon thousands of applications of linear algebra. Or I could talk about the importance of linear algebra in our digital age. Before we had computers, our primary tool for describing the world around us had been calculus. But now that we have computers, linear algebra may be even more powerful than calculus. I could also talk about the wonderful algorithmic and logical aspects of linear algebra. Or I could talk about how I see linear algebra as the place where algebra and geometry meet, lend each other forces, and become much more powerful than either subject had ever been on its own. I could talk about any of those things, but I will talk about none of those things. Instead, I will talk about one mystery whose unraveling requires all fundamental aspects of linear algebra. And this mystery is about the difference between how our eyes perceive light and how our ears perceive sound. You will agree with me that every moment of the day, we have a chance to see something breathtaking. Just look at some of these images. This is possible thanks to one extraordinary organ that we have, and that, of course, is the eye. The eye is very complex, to say the least, so we will focus on one particular aspect of one particular part of the eye, the retina, seen in this image as a red line around the perimeter on the inside of the eye. The retina is home to the light sensors called rods and cones, and it's thanks to their great numbers that we're able to see such striking images. In total, there are around 100 million of them. You can think of this number as the resolution of the eye. By comparison, the most advanced monitor today has 15 million pixels, or less than 1/6 the resolution of the eye. But what about the ear? How many sensors does the ear have that allows it to perceive such beautiful music? Actually, let me ask you the same question in a more complex situation. Suppose you're listening to this composition by Antonio Vivaldi, played by the Philadelphia Orchestra in Yankee Stadium with 50,000 fans cheering the orchestra on. How many sensors does the ear need to take in such complexity? Here, pick the number from the list that you think is about right. The answer might surprise you because it's one. There is a single signal that enters your ear, and it therefore takes a single sensor to receive it. Here's what happens. All the sounds simply get added together, and it's their sum that enters your ear. But how is that possible? How can one signal contains such richness, and how is your ear able to hear the multiple instruments and voices individually from just one signal? Well, this is the mystery that linear algebra will eventually help us solve. Meanwhile, I will show you a demo that will give you a glimpse into how a single signal can contain numerous pieces of information, and what kind of analysis needs to be performed in order to extract those individual pieces. All right, so here's what we're going to do now. I will play three notes simultaneously on this piano, and I won't tell you what those notes are. but then we'll look at the resulting audio signal in the computer, and by analyzing that signal, we'll try to determine what those notes were. So that's the task. Now, because this is a digital piano, when I play those three notes at the same time, its internal logic will add the three signals together, and then its speakers will play the resulting sum. Had it been a real piano, then the three notes would sound individually, but then the laws of physics would add up the three signals together, and in either case, this microphone receives the resulting sum. And the task we're faced with is decomposing that one signal into the individual notes. So the task that we're faced with is that of decomposition, which is taking the resulting sum and determining what elements went into that sum and in what proportion. The problem of decomposition is the first and perhaps the biggest topic in linear algebra. So it's a great place to start. So let me play those three notes at the same time, record the audio, and then we'll look at that signal on the computer. So here they are. All right, so now let's walk over to the computer and look at the result. So we're now looking at the signal that we just recorded. And please notice that it's not three different signals representing three different notes. It is a single signal representing all the notes at once. And it's our task to somehow see the individual notes in this one signal. Now we're currently fully zoomed out. And at this level of detail, we can't say much, except perhaps that the sound starts out loudly and then gradually dies out. And we're also seeing very subtle oscillations in volume, known as beats. And if you listen to the sound very carefully, you will be able to hear those beats. But at this zoom level, we don't have nearly enough detail to even begin determining the notes that were played. So let's zoom in on a very small part of our signal, right around here, that will give us sufficient detail to try and solve the problem we're facing. Having zoomed in on 4/100th of a second, we're finally seeing the complexity involved. And of course, it's this complexity that's responsible for storing such rich information in a single signal. So let's begin to analyze what we're seeing. What we're seeing is a signal that's somewhat periodic, and that's characteristic of musical tones. And there are really two major features that our eye easily picks out. First of all, we're seeing these larger oscillations, of which there are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. And on top of these larger oscillations, we're seeing smaller, more frequent oscillations that we'll count in a moment. But right there, we just did our first bit of decomposition. We have looked at one thing, and within that one thing, we saw a sum of two different things. And those two things were the larger, less frequent oscillations, and the somewhat smaller, more frequent oscillations. So that, in a nutshell, is decomposition, seeing a single thing as a sum of two different things. Let us now try to figure out what notes we're looking at. And that, of course, is determined by the frequencies of these oscillations. Now, there are 7 of the larger oscillations in the 4/100th of a second, which corresponds to 175 oscillations a second. In order to figure out what note this frequency corresponds to, let's refer to this Wikipedia article on the frequencies of musical tones. And we find out that 175 corresponds to the F in the third octave. Great, we have just determined one of the three notes. In order to identify another note, we have to determine the frequency of the smaller oscillations. Would you agree with me that there are roughly 6 of the smaller oscillations for each of the larger ones? That means that the frequency of the smaller oscillations is 175, the frequency of the large oscillations, times 6, or approximately 1050,
which corresponds to the C in the sixth octave. We have therefore been able to determine two of the three notes, and I think that's about all we can do with the naked eye.
So how well did we do? The answer is not bad at all. Let me reveal the notes that I had originally played. They were indeed the F in the third octave, followed by an A flat and a C. Here they are all together. So we nailed this F. Instead of this C, our eye picked out this C, which is a small mistake. They're very similar notes. And we did miss the A flat. But two out of three notes really isn't bad, given how simplistic our approach was. And it certainly demonstrated the linear algebra idea of decomposition, which will occupy nearly a third of our entire linear algebra course. Just imagine what we'll be able to accomplish in terms of recognizing notes once we learn a little bit of linear algebra and unleash its powerful algorithms upon this problem. Meanwhile, we really are off to a great start. So there you go. I hope that you enjoyed that presentation and that you're excited about the subject of linear algebra. Not that that presentation could make you go from not excited to now excited, but I hope that you like our informal approach and our emphasis on applications. And if that presentation didn't make total sense to you, there is nothing at all to worry about, because we're going to start at the very beginning. So welcome aboard, and let's learn some linear algebra.